Now that Michael Flynn has pleaded guilty, people are going crazy over Robert Mueller's investigation into possible collusion with Russia. However, nobody has discussed President Obama's connection to Michael Flynn. Instead, they have continued to harp on President Trump's connection to him. After officials found out that Michael Flynn lied to Vice President Mike Pence in his capacity as National Security Advisor about speaking with a Russian ambassador, he was fired after 24 days on the job. A short stint somewhat similar to that of Anthony Scaramucci, who lasted only 10 days as communications director. However, what people have failed to see is that Flynn's talks with an ambassador from Russia were done and approved under the Obama administration. In Friday, the White House announced that it was the Obama administration that authorized Flynn's communication with Russian Ambassador Sergei Kislyak during the presidential transition phase in late 2016 and early 2017. On Friday afternoon, Flynn pleaded guilty in court to lying to officials from the Federal Bureau of Investigation, specifically about his contacts with Kislyak in the month just after January when President Trump took office. He will be the first Trump official who has been taken down by the bipartisan Mueller investigation. It was reported, underscore court records indicate that his communications with Kislyak were directed by a Trump transition official, with multiple news outlets reporting that official was Trump's son-in-law and senior advisor Jared Kushner. They are saying here at the White House that Flynn's conversations with Sergei Kislyak were, quote, authorized by the Obama administration, CNN correspondent Jim Acosta said. We should point out, that is something that we have not heard before in terms of a defense from this White House, he said. Two days after Trump won against Hillary Clinton in the 2016 race, an ugly election season that saw Obama and his wife, Michelle Obama, campaign fiercely against Trump, Obama and Trump met in the Oval Office for 90 minutes to discuss national security. Flynn came up, according to media reports, but it is unclear exactly what was said. Were Flynn's Russia connections mentioned? And that's why Obama might be tapped to speak with Special Counsel Robert Mueller's investigation team about Russia's role in the 2016 campaign. Flynn pleaded guilty Friday about lying to the FBI about his conversations with Moscow before Trump was sworn in on Inauguration Day in January. But before the plea, former Acting Attorney General Sally Yates, who served in the Justice Department for 27 years, was pushed out by the Trump administration after she warned that Flynn could be blackmailed by the Russians because of his problematic conduct. So what exactly did Obama know about Flynn, and what did he tell Trump? More on Flynn, whose guilty plea could signal cooperation resulting in a lesser jail sentence. Former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn has been charged in the Special Counsel's Russia investigation with making false statements to the FBI and is expected to plead guilty at a hearing Friday morning. Special Counsel Robert Mueller's office released a one-count charging document ahead of the hearing. The false statements charge pertains to Flynn's interactions with the Russian ambassador in late December, specifically discussions about sanctions and other matters he apparently claimed never happened. According to the document, those false statements were that, on or about December 29, 2016, Flynn did not ask the government of Russia's ambassador to the United States, Russian ambassador, to refrain from escalating situation in response to sanctions that the United States had imposed against Russia that same day, and Flynn did not recall the Russian ambassador subsequently telling him that Russia had chosen to moderate its response to those sanctions as a result of his request. December 22, 2016. Flynn did not ask the Russian ambassador to delay the vote on or defeat a pending United Nations Security Council resolution, and that the Russian ambassador subsequently never described to Flynn Russia's response to his request. Look at some of the articles on this recent development. If this is true, then it would prove that it was not the Trump administration at fault because the Obama administration approved Flynn's actions. If they approved his actions and his responsibilities, then why should the Trump administration be held responsible for what he did? For many conservatives, The Mueller investigation is nothing more than a witch hunt to try and take the Trump administration down for the loss of the Clinton campaign. While for those on the left it is their chance to finally prove that the Trump campaign somehow colluded with Russian officials to win the election. Even if all the Trump officials included in the investigation plead guilty, it does not implicate President Trump and it does not leave an opening for impeachment. Share if you agree the Trump administration will continue to go strong. Follow us on Facebook at Freedom Daily.